Welcome back live today from the SALT conference here in Las Vegas, where some of the world's biggest names in finance and leading hedge fund managers are gathering here, talking about the markets and looking at alternative investments. As the markets sell off today, my next guest says a deeper recession could be on the way if governments allow their debt levels to become unsustainable. But does that mean we are in for a true double dip? Nouriel Roubini is with me. He is chairman of Roubini Global Economics, and he is out with a new book, Crisis Economics, A Crash Course in the Future of Finance by Nouriel Roubini. And of course, when you're coming out with a book, Nouriel, called Crisis Economics, right there tells the story as far as where we are in this market right now. Do you think this economy is going into a double dip?
Well, there are some parts of the global economy that are now at the risk of a double dip recession. Certainly, I see that risk in the Eurozone, where the fiscal problem, the loss of competitiveness, dynamic growth in the Eurozone was already bad before the shock to Greece, Portugal, Spain. And from here on, I see things getting worse. There's also a very anemic economic growth in Japan. There could be a double dip there. And U.S. economic growth in the second half of the year is going to slow down as the inventory adjustment goes away and as the fiscal stimulus becomes a drag on economic growth for the second half of the year.
Now, the markets today down 258 points on the Dow Jones Industrial Average. At its low, the Dow was down 356 points. I guess it started with Europe and Greece and the debt levels there, but there's all sorts of risk there. We were just in a conference together, and you told me you think this market is going to sell off 20% in the next several months.
Well, there is that risk because the problems on the macro level are first in the Eurozone. Then in China, there is elements of economic slowdown. The PMIs come out weak. There is inflation, asset bubble, credit tightening, and an attempt to slow down the economy. Japan is in trouble, and U.S. economic growth is going to slow down. So markets are now reflecting there is a greater risk of global macro problems in a situation in which now there are fiscal problems that are very severe, not just in Eurozone, but also in Japan, U.K., and the United States. And now there is also regulatory risk because we don't know how financial reform is going to occur.
How should governments be getting their arms around the debt levels? I mean, what are the solutions here?
Well, the solutions are that over the medium term, you have to control spending and raise revenues, because otherwise there is a fiscal train wreck, or if you monetize this deficit, eventually there'll be inflation. The trouble, however, is in the short run, when you raise taxes and cut spending, that's a negative effect on aggregate demand. So damn if you do, damn if you don't. If you exit too soon, you end up back into recession and inflation. If you exit too late and you monetize fiscal deficits, eventually long rates are going to go up, you have a fiscal problem or inflation, and you have another double dip. So that's the challenge that all governments are facing right now.
So what happens if they don't manage this properly? I mean, you said earlier that, you know, managing the exit strategy, managing to get your arms around the debt is one of the most difficult things. I mean, are they going to be able to do it?
Politically, I fear that many of these governments are weak and not going to be able to do the right things. You know, in the U.S., you have divided government between Republicans and Democrats not agreeing on something in the middle. In Germany, Merkel lost her majority. Sarkozy lost the election at the regional level. In places like Greece, you have riots and violence and strikes in the streets. Japan has a very weak and ineffective government. So what needs to be done? It's clear we need to raise taxes and cut spending, otherwise we're going to have a fiscal train wreck. But in many of these countries, you have divided governments, multi-party coalition governments, weak governments. Even the UK now with a hung parliament, and we'll see whether this conservative Lib kind of coalition is going to be able to do the right things. I worry not.
So do you think we are going to actually see more countries in Europe, I mean, whether it's Portugal or Spain, more countries need a bailout?
Well, already the bailout from Greece has gone to a bailout potentially of the entire Eurozone with $1 trillion of money. But even $1 trillion of money has not been able to calm the markets. That money is supposed to be available not just for Greece, but also for Portugal, for Spain, for Italy, for Ireland. The trouble, it looks like a large amount of money, but the hard slog of doing fiscal austerity, of restoring competitiveness, of doing structural reform is going to be very hard. It's going to take years of sacrifices, and expectation is the economy is going to be growth negative in many parts of the Eurozone, deflation, and then politically making sacrifices, austerity, and reform when there is continued deflation and recession is going to become politically mission impossible, certainly in Greece, possibly in other members of the Eurozone.
So let me go back to crisis economics then and ask you, how do you manage around that? I mean, here we are looking at all these crises around the world. How do I want to be invested in that scenario? If you're looking for the stock market to sell off 20% in the next several months, should I be raising cash? Should I be taking money out of the market? What's your view?
Well, I would say certainly at the margin, having more cash balances rather than risky assets. Secondly, I would also insure myself against that tail risk of a significant correction. It's expensive right now doing it, but you can buy options against those tail risk. And I would say all sorts of risky assets, whether it's equities or commodities, are going to have downside risk. Certainly, I see a weakness of the euro continuing significantly because, in relative terms, Europe is in worse shape than the United States. And commodity prices are going to also fall because you're going to have a situation of a global economic slowdown. Demand for commodities is going to fall. And with a slowdown of China and of advanced economies, even commodity prices are going to be headed lower and over the next few months.
So you want to be getting out of those asset classes then? Is there anywhere that I could hide to protect my money?
Apart from cash, I would say I would invest in short-term government bonds of countries that don't have a serious debt problem. You know, countries like, for example, Germany, maybe Canada, and a few other advanced economies that are actually, from a fiscal point of view, sounder than the weaker economies.
Let me get your take real quick on what's going on in Washington, because that's also part of the conversation here, that you've got policies coming out of Washington that are not necessarily encouraging people to put money into the market, taxes going higher next year, obviously health care expenses, and now bigger government in business.
Yes, there is this policy uncertainty that is also affecting negatively the market. We don't know what's going to be the shape of financial regulatory reform. That uncertainty is negative for financial stocks. We don't know whether we're going to raise taxes or how much next year, or whether the deficit is going to remain large. We don't know how much more government intervention is going to occur in the economy. And the two parties are so divided that the chances for bipartisanship are very, very limited. If you have division of the government, chances are this problem is not going to be resolved, and therefore the markets are worried about that. Political policy and regulatory uncertainty.
All right, Nouriel, we'll leave it there. Good to have you on the program. We appreciate your thoughts today, as always. Nouriel Roubini, Crisis Economics, his latest book. Scott, I'll send it back to you.